Okay, so now we're going to talk about all the airports that I went into trying to get away from the freak shows. So it started off in Atlanta because I lived in Alpharetta. But I wasn't staying in my apartment because someone was in and out of there putting stuff in my food. My tap water was ruined, taking my clothes, switching my clothes out, altering my clothes, whatever. So I think Buffalo was the first place I went to a Cowboy Junkies concert. Whole bunch of people showed up there. I even invited Aaron, Chaz, and Retta, and they said no, they couldn't go, but there they were, sitting with Chuck. Weirdly enough, as I was leaving the concert, these people came out of the freaking walls, dressed in black. Apparently they set up a perimeter. Margo saw it on the stage, and she's like, wow, girl, you got some friends. And I'm like, yeah, time to go. Bye. So I don't remember seeing that again. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. But Monty was there. And Aaron, Chaz, Retta were there with Chuck. I didn't see Tita, but she was probably there too. So then I guess the next place would be Miami-Dade, maybe? Tool concert? Tickets stolen. $1,100, phone, poof, gone. My fob for my alarm, had to throw away. I already talked about that in another video. I walked all over that freaking city trying to find a cell phone. $1,100, ladies, gone. Plus the tool tickets, plus the plane tickets, ticket, whatever. Plus apparently I got the rape room in the hotel I stayed in, so I had to go to the airport hotel the last night I was there. Alright, now we'll talk about Charlotte International Airport. International airports. I see the whore walking around. I see someone that looks like Madison, but she had Madison's hair, and then she had some weird face on, and she didn't have any kneecaps on her little knees. She had the little knobbiest of the knees. They're not knobby anymore. No kneecaps on her fucking knees, whore. Up, round and around and around the little driveway. Every Jeep, every freak show, I see maybe Madison, maybe Michael, maybe some kid I didn't even know I had. You fucking whore. And then the last time I went to Charlotte Airport, I had a first class ticket to, I think I was going to Dallas or Houston, I don't remember where. Maybe try and get in touch with someone at Wood Forest Bank. First class. It had a layover in Houston or Dallas, whichever one that I was going to. Stole the ticket. Mark Goodson, who's trying to look like the guy that works there, tells me I've made a mistake and my flight's not leaving until the next night. I'm like, no sir, I don't make mistakes like that. Check again. Well, apparently someone stole my ticket and no one gave a shit. The only reason I got refunded that money was because I told a security guard who was a drug guy who was walking around with a drug dog, excuse me, could you go tell that asshole I need my money back? Someone stole my ticket. I don't make mistakes like that. I sat in the airport all night long and you guys are wondering, why doesn't she get a hotel room? Why is she sitting in the airport? I'm not fucking paying for a goddamn thing for you whores. Ken Soons was there. Allie Holland was there, Aaron Diedling was there. Who else did I see there besides Mark Goodson? What the hell are you doing following me around? All right, now we're gonna talk about DC area hotels. I went to Reagan once and I went to Dulles once. I went to Reagan, I think, just to get out of the area, thinking maybe someone will notice the freak show stalkers in DC since the Capitol's right around the corner. No. So Tyler from Wood Forest Bank was there, acting like he was my friend, handing me a hotel key, and I'm going, I don't want your key room, dude. Monty was there driving his semi with the crappy ass food you switched at the Walmart. Do they not notice you people? Oh, I bought some jewelry from Madison at the jewelry store. I can't remember if it was Reagan or Dulles. At the Smithsonian jewelry store. Stolen. Just stolen. They were blue opals, excuse me. They didn't have white opals. I figured she wouldn't like them, but I was sitting in it or something, and maybe she could trade it for something else. And I bought myself something too. Stolen. And then, right, Silver Springs, Maryland, for the Follow in Reverse Wage War concert. That was the hair fiasco. And I couldn't get my tattoo. And, well, someone didn't steal my tickets, but they tried to get in the show right after me pretending they knew me, and because you have to buy two tickets. Bitch, I'm not paying for your fucking show. And then I had to leave before Falling in Reverse. I don't even think I heard one song by them because it drugged me. And like falling asleep standing up. Someone's got their like 8-year-old kid at the show. Who the fucking parents are you? You're trying to take him in the pit or something? Ken Soons is out there chatting with me and I'm going, dude, you look just like my sister's high school boyfriend named Ken Soons. Are you from Louisiana? Did you grow up in Louisiana? No, I'm from Virginia. Sure you are. Sure you are, Ken. The police officer almost jumped me because I'm drinking a water. The whatever, death water. He's like, you can't drink that beer outside. I'm like, dude, it's water. From Alpharetta. You drive up to Silver Springs, Maryland just to tell me I can't drink beer outside? You fuck the elevator up at the hotel. You're crazy. You're freaking crazy. I guess that's it. Miami-Dade, we got the hotel there, Buffalo. I went to Charlotte a few times. Thinking maybe if I went a few times, they would notice. Apparently not. Then I started going to the Atlanta airport because I had a free MARTA. Because you stole my fucking cars and I need Wi-Fi and you kicked me out of every fucking place in Alpharetta. So I'm like, well, I'll just take the MARTA all the way down to the airport and use their free Wi-Fi. But no. This dude who has Hussein on his shirt in a police uniform can't possibly see me when he's walking in. Everyone else is chatting away in the little eatery cafeteria area. He comes, goes around the column. That's a big ass fucking column that I'm not hiding behind, but you can't see me. And he says, ma'am, you're gonna have to leave. I'm like, why? What is wrong with you? Why did you come to me first? You can't possibly even see me when you're walking in. And I look at his shirt, it's Hussein, like Saddam Hussein on his shirt. And I was like, how appropriate. And he offers me money to pay for my MARTA. I'm like, dude, I don't want your money. The fuck's wrong with you?